In today's video, I have to survive 100 days as a piglin. And also, I have three objectives. First, get myself fully enchanted golden armor. Second, take out the Wither. And finally, defeat the Ender Dragon. Can I survive 100 days as a piglin in hardcore Minecraft? Keep watching and find out. So here we go, our journey begins on day one. As you can see, we're in the Nether. Pretty interesting. But to start off this journey in these 100 days, I wanted to go and collect some crimson wood so I could make a crafting table and also some sticks. So I made a crafting table and then I made the basic wooden tools, like a pickaxe and also a sword so I could defend myself. And then I found some mushrooms. Now make sure to collect these because I'll need these for food. Ah, gold. Yes, I found some gold right here. And if you didn't know, piglins love gold. This was awesome. So I was going to say hello to the skeleton right here, and I could see there was a hoglin charging at me. This was not good. Kind of panicked and then didn't know what to do. And I was hit by the hoglin, and it sent me flying in the air. Guess I can't say hello to the skeleton. Anyways, I found some gold right here. So what I decided to do was to make a golden axe, so I can collect a load of crimson wood. I would need this. And then, as I made my way out the forest, I could see to my right, there it was, a Nether fortress. So I know what I have to do. I have to go and investigate. So I headed over to the fortress, and finally, I arrived at the fortress. And I could see this place was high up. So I gathered a few blocks and made a way up. And as I got to the top, there wasn't much really, so I entered the fortress. And I had to be really careful, so I snuck around the fortress, being very careful. And then I could see there was a chest. So I headed over to the chest, opened it up, and I found some gold. I was very happy. Okay, it's time to leave the fortress and find some food. I could see right here there was a brown mushroom, so I collected that and made some mushroom soup. And I went to go and eat the soup, and it turns out piglins do not like soup. And sadly, I couldn't eat it. Oh well. And there's no way I'll be able to take that on. So I ran for my life. So I stumbled across some other piglins. So what I decided to do was to use my gold and trade with them. And maybe hopefully I could drop some food. So I used up all my gold, and sadly, I didn't get anything good. Just a fire resistant potion. As I thought, it was about to be over, but then I found a bastion. And I'm sure this place would have food, surely. So I made a bridgeway over and I entered the bastion. And as I entered the bastion, I could tell this one was a treasure room. This was great. So I had my fire resistant potion and I went to go and find some treasure. I found this chest right here. So I opened it up and it had some amazing loot. But I could tell I was getting very hungry very quick. So I had to go around the bastion and find some food. And I stumbled across another hoglin. And I had to be really careful and I had to take him out. Wow, that was close. So I had a pork chop and I healed back up. Okay, that's all that I looted up. It's now time to go around the bastion and find some more loot. I found this chest right here. And this iron sword had fire aspect too. This was truly amazing. As I was just doing my own thing, I was attacked by a little hoglin. So I panicked. Luckily, I got out of there just in time. Okay, it's about time we make a full set of iron armor. And the next day, I could see there were some hoglins and I needed food. So I used my crossbow to do damage to the hoglins. But I could see there were some other piglins trying to take my food. This was not allowed, so I had to stop them. As I made a way down, I collected all the food and then there he was. So I charged up my crossbow and took him out. So I went over to the hoglin, collected some pork chops. Anyways, I headed back down into the bastion and went to go and collect all that gold. I was not gonna leave that behind. And I have to say, there was a lot of gold here. I was a very rich piglin. So I made sure to collect all this stuff. And then I headed out there. And then before I head out the bastion, I wanted to do some trading with the piglins. I had plenty of gold, so why not? And I have to say, I got some really good things. Anyways, I headed out there and I wanted to find a place to live. And by day four, I found a second bastion. And I thought, well, this looks like a perfect spot to build my base. So I made a way up to the top of the bastion. And I could see this place needs a bit of an upgrade. Doesn't look so good. But before I do all that, I want to go around the bastion and see if I can find any loot. So I head around the bastion and I found some more gold, which was rather nice. And then, surprisingly, I found another chest. And I found a diamond pickaxe, which was amazing. So I headed back up to the top and I started placing in some blocks. And I wanted to make this place look nice. Day 5, it is now time to make the Nether portal and head to the real world. So I'll place in all the obsidian and I didn't have a flint and steel, but I did have this fire charge. So I used that to light up the nether portal, and there it is. So what am I waiting for? I headed through and got through to the other side. I could see all around me was just ocean. So I jumped down and went exploring. I made myself a boat, and I could see off in the distance. There it was, a mushroom biome. So I happily headed over there, and as I got to land, I decided to take out a few mushroom cows. I needed food. And then, as I took out this cow right here, I could see off in the distance, it was a ruined nether portal. This was exciting. So I headed over there, and I could see there was some lava. But I did find this chest right here with some useful things. So I removed all the lava, and I made the nether portal, so that I had easy access to the mushroom biome. And as I got through to the other side, I could tell I was right next to my base. This was truly amazing. So I make a bridge, and I also decided to make a bit of a staircase right here. So I had an easy way of getting up and down as well. And I have to say, this place looks pretty cool. Now I wanted to spend the next couple of days collecting a bunch of blackstone, because I wanted to build my very own base, and this would require a lot of blackstone. So I just went to the bastion and collected a ton of blackstone. Okay, finally, that should be enough blackstone. It's time to make my base. So I started clearing out a bit of space and also placing in some blackstone. And I wanted to make this place look a little bit like the bastions. And I also went with some cool designs. I wanted to make this place look amazing. What's a home without a watchtower? I don't know. So I decided to make myself a very, very simple watchtower as well. Okay, it's getting along well. Maybe a bit more decoration around and it'll look perfect. Okay, I think it's now time to work on the roof, of course. So, the block I want to use for this would be some red nether bricks. I've never really used this block before, and I wanted to change things up. So I headed back to the fortress and collected some nether wart. So I finally get home, and I do a bit of interior work to my new home. And I have to say, I like how this is going. Ah, finally, the nether bricks. And I have to say, this is becoming one of my new favorite blocks in Minecraft. Just look how cool this looks. And I think it looks awesome. What do you guys think? And with all that out the way, it is now time to head to the real world and go exploring. I headed through the mushroom biome, and then I made a boat and went across sea. And I could see off in the distance, there it was, a shipwreck. So I made a way down right here, and I found a buried treasure map. This was exciting. So I wanted to go and find the buried treasure. So I got to land, and I can't be far off. It's gotta be around here somewhere. After a bit of digging, I found it. So I opened it up, and I found some really good loot, like the heart of sea, some gold, and also some iron. Is that a village? Yes, it is. So I found this village. So what I decided to do was to go around the entire village and collect all the villagers' equipment. And then I left the village and I continue exploring. And then I noticed something off in the distance. There it was, a pillager outpost. This was not good. So I carefully made a way over to the outpost and I was greeted by some pillagers. I knew what I had to do. I had to take out all the pillagers. So I used my crossbow to take out this pillager right here. And then as I took out this pillager right here, I turned around and I could see there were so many pillagers. I had to run. So I sprinted for my life. And the bad thing was I couldn't eat golden apples for some reason. I guess piglins don't like golden apples. So I could see the pillagers are still chasing me. So I had to do a bit of parkour and get away. And then as I was sprinting through the forest, I stumbled across a village. I guess I'll be safe here for now. That was close. Day 24, I noticed there was a jungle. This was great. I was looking for a jungle and I found one. So I headed to the jungle and I found a few watermelons. So I decided to go and collect these because I'll need these for potions. So I went around the jungle exploring. I wanted to see if I could find anything else. Is that a ravine? Yes, it is. I found a ravine, which is pretty cool, I guess. Hey, and also, check this out. I found this nether portal. And yeah, just look at this place. And you know what I'm gonna do now? I'm gonna make another nether portal and head back home. So I collected a few bits of obsidian and made a brand new nether portal. And surprisingly, my base was not very far away at all. This was great. Then finally, I get back home. Wow, it's so nice to be home. And to finish off a day, I made a potion area so that I could make my very own potions. Hey, I also noticed I haven't really been building that much, have I? So I decided to make a brand new house and also a new path. And I can't forget about a farm. So I decided to make a cow farm. What's a cow farm without cows? I don't know. So I headed to the mushroom biome and went to go and find some mushroom cows. And surprisingly, I found a few. All I had to do now was to take them back to their new home. And then finally, I brought the cows to their new home, and I could tell they was very happy. And I was not sure if the piglins would attack these cows, so I decided to make them a bit of a glass wall right here, so they would be safe. And I think now it's time for a little tour. Starting off right here, we have our nice pathway with some black stone walls and also these crimson trees that I made. Let me know what you guys think of these. And then this way, we have our potion area. This is where we make our potions. And then we have this house. Not too sure what to use this place for just yet. I'll think about it. So we enter my house and we have this nice floor design right here and also some lighting. And over here, this is where we have our chests, furnaces, and also crafting tables. And I have to say, I really like the roof design. Coming outside, we have our mushroom cow farm. I'm not too sure what to build here just yet. Anyways, I head back indoors and make some golden armor. And there it is, we now have golden armor. Okay then, I think it's now time we go on a bit of a mining trip. So I headed back to the real world and found a cave. I made sure to go around and collect a few bits of iron, because I'll need this. And then I stumbled across a ravine, and off in the distance, I found some gold. So I jumped down, and surprisingly, I found a mob spawner. But first, I wanted to go and collect all the gold. So I did that, and then headed to the mob spawner. It turns out this is a spider spawner, which is pretty cool. So I opened up a chest and I found a name tag. Awesome. And then, as I explored the caves, there it was. Diamonds. This was truly amazing. So I went to go and collect all the diamonds. There was only three, so what I decided to do was to go and find some more. And after a bit of digging, I found some. I was a super happy piglin. And also, I can't forget, I made sure to go and collect some obsidian as well, because I'll need this for the enchantment table. And finally, I head back to the surface and go home. So I finally get home, and then I make the enchantment table. And there it is. And there it is, wow. We finally have the enchantment table. But the enchantment table is not finished yet. I have to find a library. But first, I have to go back to the Nether and go and collect a few blaze rods. So I had my fire resistant potion, and then I went to go and get some blaze rods. And I'd only need a few of these. I think 5 would be enough. Okay, that should do it. It's time to head back home. So I finally get home, and you know what I do. I make some Eyes of Ender, and it's now time to go and find the stronghold. So I threw my Eye of Ender, and it broke. Anyways, for the next couple of days, I went searching for the stronghold. And I could see off in the distance, there were some ice spike biomes. This is pretty cool. Found it. I found the stronghold, which is amazing. All I have to do now is to go and find the library. And then, as I broke these blocks right here, I couldn't believe my eyes. There was a library. So I didn't hesitate, and I started collecting some books. Hey, and I also found this chest right here with some really good enchanted books. Don't mind me taking these. I might use these for some armor stands. And then, as I entered through this doorway right here, I could see there was the end portal. So I approached the end portal. I could see we only needed a few more ender eyes. Actually, we need loads more. Anyways, I left the stronghold. So once I was in the real world, I decided to go and find a few more things. I stumbled across this village right here. Hey, I found an igloo. So I headed down and I found a zombie and also a chest right here. So I opened up a chest and I found some apples, which is quite nice. And that was it really, nothing else. So I decided to leave the igloo. So I finally arrive home and make some bookshelves. And now I need a place for this enchantment table to go. Found this spot, so I placed in the enchantment table and also placed in a bunch of bookshelves. And then some decoration. But oh no, I wasn't going simple. I wanted this place to look amazing. So I decided to add a few pillars around and also this really cool design. And I made sure to take my time on this because I wanted this place to look very special. Hey, and I also made these fire torches as well. And I have to say, they look awesome. And after that, I made a diamond sword and also a diamond pickaxe. And I went to go and enchant them. But sadly, I didn't have enough levels, unfortunately. So I had to go out and collect a load more. But before I did that, I want to go back to the real world and go and collect a bunch more food. I was very low on food, and I was a very hungry piglin. Okay, I think that should do it. should be enough food. It's time to go back to the Nether and go and collect some levels. Three levels. That should be enough. It's time to head back to base and enchant all my armor. So I finally get back to the base and I go and enchant all my gold armor. And I got some really good armor. I think it was like protection 4 on every single piece, which was amazing. And then I could see there was a fortune 3 pickaxe. I had to do it. So I finally enchant my helmet and I could see there was a smite 4. I wanted this, but sadly I didn't have enough levels. So I quickly got some levels and then I enchanted my diamond sword. And there it is, wow. We finally have fully enchanted gold armor. And after that, I put all my old armor onto an armor stand. Day 51, I wanted to make some health potions. So I made a few health potions and I had to go and test them. I had to make sure they wouldn't poison me. So I had a health potion right here and it worked. I was a very happy piglin. And then later on that day, I wanted to now go and find some more bastions. I wanted to get myself some more loot. I could see off the distance there was a bastion, so I headed over there. And as I entered the bastion, I could tell there was loads of gold here. And I wanted to collect all the gold, and there was so much gold here, which was amazing. I also found this chest right here, so I opened up and found some diamond armor, which was very nice. But I wanted to find a second bastion as well, so I headed out and I found one. And I found a looting one. Iron sword. This is pretty cool, but the second chest had a diamond pickaxe, and this diamond pickaxe had mending. This was truly amazing. So I went around the bastion, I found this another chest right here, I opened it up, and there it was, pickstep. And finally, our third and final bastion. Just look how much gold's here. Once again, I entered the bastion, and I found some more gold. And I have to say, I was pretty rich after this. I found loads of gold. And then, you wouldn't believe this, as I opened up this chest right here, I found a looting 2 diamond sword. So I was super excited, so I decided to leave the bastion and go home. Day 63. Finally, we arrive home and I make a music box so I can actually play pickstep. And as well, I combined my pickaxe with another pickaxe to make the ultimate pickaxe. And I also turned it into netherite as well. And then I headed back to the real world and collected some sand so I could actually make some bottles and make some potions. And now the next day, I wanted to go back to the fortress and collect some wither skeleton heads. But this took a really long time. Collecting all these wither skeleton heads was not so easy. And with that looting 2 sword, yeah, no good really. And then finally, there it was, a wither skeleton head. And we now have all the wither skeleton heads. We can now take on the wither. It is now time to take on the wither. So I headed out, and by the next day, I found this spot. So I placed in each bit of soul sand carefully, and then finally, the wither skeleton heads. And there he was, the wither. So I backed up the quickest I could and then charged up my crossbow. So I shot the wither with my crossbow and I could tell straight away he was not happy whatsoever. I also used my crossbow to do the most damage that I could to the wither. And surprisingly, I got him down to half health. But the wither was also doing damage to me and I had to run. I couldn't believe it. I was hit by the wither and I fell down into the ravine. But luckily, there was some water, which saved my life. Okay, it's now time to end this fight. So I healed back up and I took my final swings. And there it is. Wow, we did it. So I collected the Nether Star and it's now time to head home. Day 77, I finally arrive home and I make the beacon. And I thought, this looks like a perfect spot for the beacon. So I placed in a bunch of gold and for some reason, it didn't work. I guess it doesn't work in the Nether. So I headed to the real world and placed in some gold. And finally the beacon, and there it is. So I equipped it with a jump boost so I could jump very high. And as I was jumping around, I noticed this place. Why don't I turn this place into my base? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna spend the next couple of days terraforming this area into my base. there it is. We have our beacon area, our nether portal, and also this house as well. I didn't do too much building. I wanted to make this place look very simple. But there was one thing I did want to do. I wanted to go back to the nether, and I wanted to make a bridge here. This bridge, yeah, doesn't look so good. So I'm going to spend a little while making a new one. And yeah, that looks a lot better. What do you guys think? It's not the best thing in the world, but it definitely looks a lot better. Day 84, I now wanted to go and find some ancient debris. And like usual, this took a very long time, and I only wanted a little bit. But for some reason, luck was not on my side, and it took me a very long time to find all this ancient debris. So I finally get back to base, and I turn my diamond chestplate and also leggings and sword into netherite. And finally, I wanted to make a bunch more potions. It is now time. It is now time. It is now time to go and defeat the Ender Dragon. So I gathered all the stuff I needed from my chest, all the equipment and stuff I would need, and then I headed out. It's now time to take on the Ender Dragon. Finally, after days of traveling, I finally arrive at the portal. So I place in all the Eyes of Ender, and there it is, the end portal. So I didn't hesitate, and I jumped through. As I got through to the other side, there she was, the Ender Dragon. And she instantly started firing fireballs at me. I could tell the Ender Dragon was not happy whatsoever. But that didn't stop me. I had to go and destroy all the end crystals. I used the crossbow to take out all the end crystals one by one. And I could tell the Ender Dragon was not so happy. She charged at me instantly and did a bit of damage. That wasn't going to stop me. I only had one more end crystal left. So I took my final shot and there it is. All the end crystals have been destroyed. And now it is now time to take out the Ender Dragon. So I used my crossbow to go and do the most damage that I could. And then I was a bit scared because I thought the Ender Dragon would knock me into the air. But luckily that didn't happen, and I started doing damage to the Ender Dragon once again. But unfortunately, the Ender Dragon flew away. But that was okay. I collected a few Ender Pearls right here because I might need these. And then finally, it is now time to end this. So I waited for the right opportunity and I striked. And there it is. Wow, we did it. We finally defeated the Ender Dragon. Wow, that's a lot of XP. So I collected up all the XP because I'll need this for enchanting. And I almost forgot. I made sure to go and collect the dragon egg as well. And there it is. Wow, we did it. All I have to do now is to go home. So I finally get home, and I wanted to spend the next couple of days taking my time and building a place for the Ender Dragon egg to go. So I flattened up a bit of ground right here. I started off by placing a few quartz blocks and also some quartz stairs as well. And I thought, why not use a bit of ancient debris as well? So I used that, and also I thought I'll place a bit of obsidian in. And it's a good thing I did that. This place looks epic. And then finally, I got to place in the Ender egg. And there it is. Wow, we did it. And there it is, day 100. Wow. We finally did it. We finally survived 100 days as a piglin in hardcore Minecraft. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys all next time. Peace out.